I think that it just has such a unique impact. I think that people have discovered that it really holds a very special place in the repertoire. So I'm thrilled every time I get a chance to do it. I actually got to know the piece kind of a long time ago because my teacher, growing up, was really taken with the piece at a time when very, very few people played it. This would have been in the, you know, late 80s, early 1990s. I studied the piece as a teenager, but at that point, there wasn't really much opportunity to perform it. So many years later, probably around 2008 or something like that, that I was first getting asked to play it. And then when Britten's 100th birthday came up in 2013, I think there was a lot of playing of his pieces, and people started playing it a lot more at that point. I was lucky because I'd known it for so long. You know, it felt sort of like an old friend at that point. It's really a very, very special piece, nothing quite like it. Well, Britten was very profoundly affected by the Spanish Civil War. He was a pacifist. He, in fact, left the United Kingdom to go to America and Canada at the beginning of the Second World War. So this piece is thought to be a reflection on his thoughts on the Spanish Civil War, on war in general. I mean, there are elements of it where I think one can hear a little bit of Spanish influence, but, I mean, it sort of floats in these different worlds between, you know, dreaminess and kind of terror, I think. And there's an ambiguity to the ending that I think is really, in a way, the most remarkable thing about the piece. I think it really makes you think about it. You know, when it's over, the processing of the piece doesn't end. I think that it remains in your mind, kind of remains in your body for quite a while afterwards. Benjamin Britten was a man at odds with the world. On the surface, his music would seem to be decorative, positive, charming, and it's so much more than that. When you hear Britten's music, if you really hear it, you become aware of something very dark. I think that's very true. I mean, with Britten's music, for me, the thing that's most fascinating about it is, you know, there's some music that you experience at the moment that you hear it. And with Britten's music, I feel the metaphor for me is like, it's like planting a seed, and then you give it water and you take care of it, and it starts to sprout and it starts to grow. And yeah, and if you make the investment in Britten's music, it becomes so much more than you might feel initially that it is. And yes, if you scratch underneath the surface, you peel away these layers, and it becomes more and more magical.